Good morning, students. We were talking about the common name system. And in common name system, I've explained to you that there are no certain set rules. And it is based on the source from which an organic compound is obtained or the property exhibited by the organic compound. And while dealing with such type of nomenclature, that is common name system, we have to use terms like normal, iso, neo, tertiary and secondary before assigning common name to a given organic compound. Now let us talk about the terms used here like normal, secondary, iso, tertiary, neo. When these terms are to be used before the common name of the given organic compound. So yesterday or in the previous lecture we have completed the common name of hydrocarbons, that is alkane. Today we will start with the common name for alcohol. Alcohol having general representation as ROH. Now, in common name system, this R part is treated as alkyl part. You know it very well that when one hydrogen is removed from alkane, we always get alkyl group. So here, this R part is treated as alkyl and the OH part is treated as alcohol. So all alcohols according to common name system are named as alkyl alcohol. So before we start assigning common name to alcohol, let us talk about some basic concepts or the concept which are of prime importance to common name system. That is about their alkyl groups, the types of alkyl groups. So here I have written CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. A hydrocarbon which contains 4 carbon atoms. According to IUPAC, this is called butane, and according to common name system, this is called normal butane because branching is absent. For getting branching or to get a branch structure, we require at least 4 carbon atoms, or we can say branching starts with 4 carbon atoms. For 3 branching is not possible, for 2 branching is not possible, and for 1 branching is impossible. So here it's N-butane. Now this carbon is called 1 degree carbon, you know it very well. This carbon is called 2 degree carbon. So if one hydrogen atom in normal butane is replaced from 1 degree carbon atom, it can be this carbon atom or it can be this carbon atom. We have to remove one edge from 1 degree carbon atom. So what we will get? We will get CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2 dash. This group is called normal butyl group. So if one edge, that is 1 degree, is removed from normal butane, we get normal butyl group. But if the edge from 2 degree carbon atom or secondary carbon atom. Then we will get CH3, CH2, CH dash, CH3 group. And this group is called secondary butyl group. Because hydrogen is removed from secondary carbon atom. Now, few more. CH3, CH, CH3, CH3. This is the case of isobutane. I've told you in previous class that if a second last carbon atom is having two methyl group attached, then we have to term iso. We have to use term iso before the common name of the given hydrocarbon. So here, this is the case of isobutane. In isobutane, we are having one 3 degree carbon atom. This is your 1 degree carbon atom, this is your 1 degree carbon atom, this is your 1 degree carbon atom. Now, if one hydrogen atom is removed from 1 degree carbon atom, then we will obtain CH3, CH, CH3, CH2 dash group, and this group is called isobutyl group. Is called isobutyl group. So isobutane gets converted to isobutyl group if one primary hydrogen atom is removed or replaced. But if H atom is removed from 3 degree carbon atom, then we will get CH3C, CH3, CH3 dash group. Because a valence is created on 3 degree carbon atom, this group is called tertiary butyl group. Tertiary butyl group. And similarly, with the case of neopentane, you know when to use neo. When we have one 4 degree carbon atom present in a given hydrocarbon or a given organic compound, then neo term is to be used. The simplest member of neo is the neopentane, because the carbon atom, when surrounded by 4 more carbon atoms, will get total 5 carbon atoms. So neo starts with neopentane. Now, if one H from any of the 1 degree carbon atom is removed or replaced from neopentane, then we will obtain neopentyl group. If a hydrogen atom which is 1 degree or primary is replaced from neo compounds, here it's neopentane, then we obtain neoalkyl group, and here it is neopentyl group. Now let us use these concepts, basic concepts, to name some alcohols. So here the starting member CH3OH is called methyl alcohol, or it is also called wood spirit because it is obtained by the destructive distillation of wood. CH3CH2OH is called ethyl alcohol, or it is also called grain alcohol or grain spirit because it is obtained by the fermentation of grains or cereal crops. Now the next one is CH3CH2CH2NOH. The OH group is attached on 1 degree carbon atom, so this alcohol is called normal propyl alcohol. Now the important part. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2 dash and OH. Here is a valency created by removal of hydrogen atom. Stretching and valence is created over 1 degree carbon atom. So here the group obtained is called normal alkyl group, because it contains 4 carbon atom, so it is called normal butyl group. Now when 1H is replaced by OH, we will get alcohol compound. So this compound is called normal butyl alcohol, because the unsatisfied valency is satisfied by OH group. We have obtained alcohol. Now the next one, a valency is created over 2 degree carbon atom and it's a straight chain compound. Straight chain and valency is created over 2 degree carbon atom or secondary carbon atom. So we are getting normal alkyl group, because it contains 4 carbon atoms. So normal alkyl group here will be normal butyl group. Now the valence is satisfied by OH group, so this alcohol is called secondary butyl alcohol. The next is CH3CH CH3CH2 dash OH. Now see here, this group is having CH3CH CH3 unit, which is called iso unit, and a valency is created over 1 degree carbon atom. So the group obtained is isoalkyl group. As it contains 4 carbon atom, so the group obtained is called isobutyl group. Now the valency is satisfied by OH group, it means it's a member of alcohol, so this compound is called isobutyl alcohol. Then next case, OH atom is removed from 3 degree carbon atom, so the group obtained will be tertiary alkyl group. Here we are having 4 carbon atom, so the group obtained is called tertiary butyl group. Now the valency is satisfied by OH group, so this alcohol is called tertiary butyl alcohol. Remember, in isoalkyl alcohol, OH group is there on 1 degree carbon atom, on 1 degree carbon atom, and in tertiary alkyl alcohol, the OH group is there over 3 degree carbon atom. Then we have a case of 5 carbon atom straight chain and OH is there over 1 degree carbon atom. So definitely it is the case of normal alkyl alcohol. So the alcohol is called normal pentyl alcohol. It is also called amyl alcohol, normal amyl alcohol. In common name for 5 carbon atom, we can use amyl. So it is normal pentyl alcohol or it is normal amyl alcohol. Now as we are having 5 carbon atom, so case of neo is possible. But before we discuss neo case, let us discuss about the iso case. What is required? We require CH3CH CH3 unit on one side, and on the other side the group should be there on 1 degree carbon atom. So here we are having group OH on 1 degree carbon atom as well as CH3CH CH3 unit. So it's the case of isoalkyl alcohol, because it is having 5 carbon atom, so it is called isopentyl alcohol or it is called isoamyl alcohol. And the neo case, we require a 4 degree carbon atom. Here we are having a 4 degree carbon atom and OH group is here on 1 degree carbon. So it is the case of neo alkyl alcohol. As we are having 5 carbon atoms, so this is called neopentyl alcohol. This is all about the common name for alcohol. Thank you.